with more than 35 nations, 30,000 people, and a million components working together, we share one simple goal: to illuminate the way to new energy.
So this is the cutout of the ITER machine, the largest fusion machine ever built on Earth. And believe me, as an engineer, it's very exciting to work in this project. So fusion is a reaction when two light nuclei are merged together and there is a release, tremendous release of energy that will help us reproduce the energy produced in the stars and on the sun. So inside the machine, we have the plasma, and this plasma should be very, very hot, much hotter than the sun. It's around 115 million degrees. Not only the plasma should be dense enough and should be stable enough, the only way to do it is by confining the plasma. This is done with the help of the superconducting magnets, which are a set of poloidal field coils and the coils of the central solenoid, and they can maintain the plasma and they can control the position and the shape of the plasma. However, this is not enough to stabilize the plasma in vertical direction, and this is why we need the in-vessel coils. So what we are trying to do here is to bring the sun on Earth. And this is a very challenging engineering job. The engineering is mainly men's world, so I have always worked among men. So very interesting.
In the fusion area, women are underrepresented. And one way to get more women recruited at ITER is to have more women apply, to have more women know about ITER. And how do you do that? Well, you spread the word. You just create an environment where this just becomes easier. Just like with any professional network. So if you have a woman who is heavily involved in child-rearing and family duties, she probably has less time writing or reading articles. So what is it that we can do here for the women at ITER? What are the things that are concretely missing to make certain things just a little bit easier?
Networking is really important, not only for women to network with women, but women to network with men.
A network in general, even women or men, whatever, it's just an opportunity to get easy access to real experience and just so many different perspectives.
A way to create open conversation to really challenge the norms in engineering.
At the university, I was the only girl. Woman.
In a class of 70 students, there are 10 girls and the rest are all guys. In my family, I'm actually the first girl child to go to another country to do work or study or anything.
Of course, when I participate in the meetings or conferences, I tend to be surrounded by the many men, engineers or scientists. So people may think I'm a brave and I'm a special woman.
Especially in physics, I would say. I feel a sort of somewhere, you know, a bias that, yeah, you are a woman, then, you know, it becomes like they think maybe you're not that intelligent. I don't think it's a conscious thing, but subconsciously you can feel that.
I've been working in science communications at science organizations for many years. There's often been this lack of gender equity in those types of organizations.
The next job I had was at a petrochemical facility in South Texas. They couldn't associate to me. I was either their mother or their sister. They couldn't see a professional woman giving them instructions, technical advice. I didn't last long there.
But when I went into science publishing, for example, I had the experience of hitting the glass ceiling. I had a very good salary, a good position, but I was doing well and I was expecting to be promoted and to have a salary increase reflecting that. And for 3 years, it didn't happen. And I saw my male colleagues were. And I really thought it was unfair. And in fact, that's the reason I left that organization.
Choose an organization that you're going to work with. I learned to look on the board of directors to see if there's any women. And if there weren't, I didn't apply.
A women's organization, it kind of helps us to bond with people, to support each other in any case of need.
The women network will help me to get to know other women and also the men working on the construction site. So if you have some systematic support system to women and also the network within the women, that will be very, very useful.
But of course we want to do more. We could work more with the ITER values. Everybody thinks about inclusion and diversity. Well, how about trust? You know, do I trust the organization, my colleagues, to see me for the professional that I am, not for what I wear or how I look or how I talk? And the other way around, do they trust me to be who I am, to contribute, to do I trust to be given the same opportunities, the same advancement opportunities, the same place at the table, the same amount of speaking time?
It's more in the day-to-day practical way that we work that organizations need to be much more aware of, making it easier for women to sustain having a family and their career.
There are a lot of rules and restrictions in the society for women, like you can't do this, don't do that.
Especially in Japan, the woman, working woman like me, as a single, is a rat. No, don't define or don't create a stereotype for working women, and just open the door and welcome everybody.
If you feel the passion for science, if you feel the passion for engineering, just go ahead and do it.
I'm very happy that we're able to launch this at ITER. We're developing a network. Everybody is just here to help you too and wants you to succeed.
Don't be afraid. If you make a mistake, well, you can learn from it. There's plenty of lessons you can learn from making mistakes.
Believe in yourself. Be confident.
Do your best. Do whatever you want to do. And I'm sure you will succeed in that. Maybe in the beginning it seems like probably you would fail, but it won't. I mean, you have to keep on trying and you will finally succeed.
We rely only on your own capabilities and try to achieve it with your own knowledge and hard work.
Having visits here where children of all ages and all genders get to hear women engineers talking about substance, talking about the machine, they will grow up being completely used to the fact that women can talk about plasma boundaries. You know, it's something that that we want to do more.
As you can see here, we are approaching the vacuum vessel wall with all the cooling pipes for the manifolds, with all the little diagnostics that are shown here in the loops. And then we have the in-vessel coils that are made of a very stiff mineral insulated conductor. They are attached with the help of brackets made of Inconel 625. But of course, first you do the winding of the conductor, which is a 3D winding, which is very complicated.
It's a different type of approach. We need to work primarily for the women at ITER, expanding the space, but also keep an eye on the future generations of scientists.
If you have the will to do something, then nothing is difficult. Just do what makes you happy. Forget about the world and follow what your heart says. That's the best thing.
Happy International Women's Day.
Happy International Women's Day.
Next on ITER NOW, we'll explore the scientific and engineering challenges that make ITER one of the most exciting projects in the world. Future episodes will feature the plasma-facing components, the diverter, the tokamak cooling system, and much more. Thanks for your comments and suggestions, and we'll see you next time on ITER NOW.